Here's a computer we just got recently. It's not exclusively for me, but I figured I might as well do a video about it while I have it. On the outside, it looks a lot like my ThinkPad T60, except it only says ThinkPad on the outside. It doesn't say IBM. On the left side, there's a cooling vent, VGA port, Ethernet, 3 USB ports, full-size display port, not mini display port, and a smart card reader. On the front, there's the latch to open it, and an SD card reader. On the right, there's an ExpressCard slot, wireless switch, eSATA port, headphone jack, which also supports headphones with a built-in microphone, DVD-RW drive, a 4th USB port, FireWire port, and Kensington lock slot. On the back, there's a phone jack for a modem, the battery, power jack, and more cooling vents. On the outside, it has indicators for battery and sleep mode. To open it up, we just slide the switch and lift it up. However, the hinges are pretty stiff, so we need 2 hands. And here it is, the Lenovo ThinkPad T410. This is a computer from 2010, so it's almost 11 years old. We got it pretty cheaply as an inexpensive computer to replace my family's HP Stream laptop, which still works, but it really doesn't perform very well with any operating system I've tried. I might do some comparison videos in the future, but for now this is a video about this computer itself. This is our first computer with an Intel Core i5 and designed for Windows 7. It is a Core i5 M520 at 2.4 GHz, dual core with hyper-threading. It has 4 GB of memory, which can be upgraded to 8, but I haven't done that yet. It came with a slow mechanical hard drive, but I replaced it with an SSD and installed Windows 10, as you can see. So now let's log in with the fingerprint reader this computer has. It's right here. And here's Windows 10. The screen flickers because this backlight looks like this on camera when the brightness is not all the way up, so let's turn it up. It's really bright for me right now, but at least it's not flickering on camera anymore. The keyboard might look a little weird because the seller put some labels on the keys to adapt it to the Italian keyboard layout. As you can see by the short enter key and the labels on the keys themselves, this is not an Italian keyboard. If this computer was mine, I would peel those labels away because I actually use the US International keyboard as my main keyboard layout, but since this computer is not for me, I left those labels on. It has a 14-inch screen with a resolution of 1280 by 800, so it's 16 by 10 aspect ratio, or 8 by 5 if you want to reduce the fraction. The keyboard doesn't have a backlight, but like my T60, it has the ThinkLight, this little LED at the top to illuminate the keyboard when it's dark. Over here there are indicators for Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. I'm not sure why it doesn't have the Bluetooth logo anymore, like my T60. Maybe they couldn't pay the license to show the Bluetooth logo anymore. And drive activity. Also the power button lights up. The speakers are on the sides of the keyboard, and they actually don't sound as good as the ones on my T60. They sound good and are quite loud, but are a little bit more tinny. They have less bass, and my T60's speakers didn't have much bass already. Let's open the system properties so you can see the specs that I've already mentioned. It doesn't have a touch screen, but it says touch support because of the touchpad. You can do gestures on it. When I got this computer, it had Windows 7, but when I changed the drive, I did a clean installation of Windows 10. And it wasn't activated at first, but I put the Windows 7 product key that was included with this computer. It's under the battery, and it activated just fine, so that's good. It found most driver updates on Windows Update. So pretty much everything in this computer works. My T60's SATA speed is only SATA 1, even though it's still really fast with an SSD. This computer has SATA 2 speed, so it's a bit faster. I'll show you by restarting. This computer only has legacy BIOS or MBR. It doesn't have EFI. I'm gonna use my fingerprint reader here. And there you go, started up pretty quickly. So would I recommend this ThinkPad T410 in 2021? If you can find one for cheap, I guess so. As a main computer, I don't think it's really recommended, but my T60 is still good for basic tasks, so this one is gonna be even better. Web browsing, watching videos, stuff like that will work perfectly on this computer. Even documents, music. You can watch DVDs with the built-in optical drive or listen to music CDs. And with four USB ports, you can plug in more things than most modern computers. Even my newer ThinkPad T440S only has three USB ports. So that's pretty cool. The screen isn't amazing, but at least it's taller than 16:9, so web pages and other stuff that scrolls vertically looks a bit better. I tried the webcam, it's not very good. You need a lot of light to be seen, but at least it's there. The microphone is also not spectacular, but it works. If this computer was mine, I'd be happy to do many operating system tests, since it's quite a bit more powerful than my T60 with Core 2 Duo from 2006. But because this computer was bought to do some light but serious work, I decided to put a supported operating system on it. And even though I haven't had it very long, it does seem to work fine. I also installed Core Temp to check on the temperature. When the CPU is maxed out, it gets up to 70-80 degrees Celsius, but not any hotter than that. So, not too bad. I also installed Lenovo Vantage, but for some reason I cannot set a charge threshold, even though the system interface foundation drivers are installed. This computer came with a non-original battery, but I also have a non-original battery for my T60, and charge thresholds work there, so I'm not sure if that's the problem. I try installing the Lenovo copy of Windows 7 on it, including all the Lenovo software, and then try upgrading it to Windows 10, but I wanted a cleaner installation. Besides, this battery doesn't seem to have very good life, so even though it's at 100% every time, it's already pretty deteriorated. In my tests, I've seen that it lasts about 2 hours, maybe an hour and a half, so not amazing, but it could be worse. And it's the smaller battery, the one that doesn't protrude out. Even though it's not as energy efficient as newer computers, it still performs very well over 10 years later. You may like newer ThinkPads a little more, like the T420, T430, T440, and so on. But anything with an Intel Core i5 processor or better is going to be decent enough. As you probably know, first generation technology stuff doesn't age very well, but they didn't change that much when they introduced the Core i series. So it's still pretty good. I may do some follow-up videos where I compare the performance of this computer with my other ThinkPads or with our newer but cheaper HP Stream laptop, which is very energy efficient, has good battery life, but is really underpowered. A bit like netbooks back when this T410 was brand new. So I'm gonna turn down the brightness, because otherwise I'll get a headache. And thank you for watching.